Hey everyone, it's Amy and Ben here to chat again.
Hey.
We're from Lounge Room Empire, where we're conquering the world one armchair at a time. I am trying to get into BookTube.
Ooh,
it's a very, what would you call it? Gated community on YouTube.
Okay, so what is it exactly?
So BookTube is the area.
Yeah.
On YouTube, and I say area in inverted commas because it's like not a literal area, but yeah. More like the same way the cloud is not a cloud.
I'm gonna get a really bad analogy here that's not technically correct.
So anyway, it's a community on YouTube for book lovers, and they do things. It's kind of like people who were on book blogs have now transitioned or nomadically gravitated towards YouTube and started talking about their books.
Yeah, that's nothing like the cloud. But yeah, okay, mm-hmm. Cool. Mm-hmm. And so when you say you're trying to get into it, is that mean you just want to start doing some videos that are relevant to book blogging?
Yeah, so I think with Lounge Room Empire, we're always on a journey with this channel. And we have so many loves and passions for things that Lounge Room Empire to us at the moment conveys not only TV and computer games and movies, but also books.
Yeah.
And really anything else that sort of suits our fancy at the time. Anything
we discuss or do in the lounge room that is PG rated
or below. Yeah.
So with that in mind, so you wanted to have a chat about the current, is it the top five or the top 10 contestants for Booker Prize?
So what I wanted to do was talk about the fact that my way of getting into the BookTube community is to show you my chops.
All right.
At literary reading.
Okay.
So I'm going to be reading from the long list of the Man Booker Prize.
And sorry, when you say reading, do you mean reading books and then reviewing them? Or are you just going to read them on YouTube to show that you can
both,
read?
Both, actually. I'm going to be doing some ASMR videos on silent reading. Yep. And I'm also going to actually be reading the books and reacting to them and reviewing and recommending as I go through.
And just a quick question. How does one know that you are reading silently?
They just watch me read silently.
Oh, okay. So there's no sound.
No. Except maybe fire crackling. But anyway, that's getting off topic. That's ASMR. This is reading. So the Booker Prize, do you want to ask me anything about it?
I think I did before. I just let you know that I would definitely ask. Is what is the Booker Prize?
So I've always referred to it as, this book was Booker Prize nominated, etc. Yeah. It's a literary fiction award. Probably the most popular
or
well-known award in literary fiction in the world.
Okay.
So they start with a panel of judges
who
takes all the books that have been released that particular literary year, shall we say, kind of like a financial year, but a literary year from October to October, I think.
Yeah.
And then they choose from that long list some shortlist candidates. And I think there's about six of them. So you go 13, then six.
Yep.
And then finally, there's a winner of the Booker Prize.
And is this any novel written by any novelist in the world? Or are there any restrictions?
There are restrictions, but they've been broadened in recent years.
Yep.
So from its inception, only novels written by Commonwealth, Irish, and South African, and later Zimbabwean citizens were eligible.
Yep.
And then in 2014, it was widened to any English language novel, which has caused controversy in the past.
Okay.
But they're still sticking with that, I guess, for the last 5 years at least. So
it sounds a bit more, inclusive, particularly when you have migration. So, you know, there's big expat communities in places like Singapore.
Yeah.
You know, a whole host of other places. So it sounds like it's a good decision. But with that in mind, so were you going to go through the long list, the short list, or the winner at this stage?
So I'm going through the long list. Ooh, yeah. So I'm starting with 13 books.
Yep.
It's going to be an interesting journey.
Yeah.
I've read a couple of them. So I wanted to just, at this stage, go through and give you an indication of what I know about each book.
Yep.
And just set out the list of what books I'm going to be reading over the next couple of months and what books you will see reacted to on YouTube, probably as a book discussion. With yourself, I'll rope you in on most of them, I guess, as I do. And let's go through it. Let's hop to it. The first one is it's not really a surprise here. So, you know The Handmaid's Tale on TV?
Yeah.
Margaret Atwood, who has been a long time favorite author of mine, wrote The Handmaid's Tale in the 80s, and somehow it's suddenly gotten feminist wings everyone's kind of gone, oh, wow, look at this amazing novel that was written 30 years ago. She's now done a follow-up to The Handmaid's Tale all these years later, given the success.
Oh, yeah, that makes
sense. It's called The Testaments.
Interesting.
I don't know anything else about it. It's definitely a sequel because you look at the cover and it's pretty much exactly the same, just a different color.
Ooh.
So that's that for that one.
Okay.
That's that.
That's that.
Night Boat to Tangier by Kevin Barry. Okay. I have NFI.
Okay.
So everything to discover, nothing to know yet.
Yep.
My Sister the Serial Killer by Oyinkin Braithwaite.
Good work pronouncing that name.
Yeah, thank you. I don't know if it's correct, but I'm trying my best and trying not to be offensive. She's the only debut novel on this list.
Oh, wow. Okay. So,
everyone's been established prior to the list.
Okay, cool. And do you know anything about that one?
I've read it.
Okay. Oh, so...
So that reaction will be up shortly.
Watch this space.
Yeah. I really enjoyed it. I just want to say that's just a little preface to the reaction I'm going to give.
Yeah.
If anyone else out there has read it, let me know.
Worth the nomination?
Yeah, I think so. Definitely, if it's a debut, it's. I really enjoyed it, but I'll talk about it with a bit more flair and aplomb.
Yeah.
Ducks Newburyport by Lucy Ellman. All I know about this one is that it's 1,000 pages or so.
Okay.
So I looked for it on Audible.
A very generic thing to know, yeah.
Yeah, I looked for it on Audible and I was like, damn, I'm not going to be able to go 1,000 pages over 24 hours or anything like that. I'm going to have to read the actual novel.
Okay.
That's okay. I like these meandering. I'm hoping it's a little bit domestic.
Yep.
A little bit pastoral maybe, because the Ducks Newburyport, I just think of ducks being pastoral.
Yep.
Anything other than that,
Could be about the Mighty Ducks.
No, I don't think so.
No, okay, worth a shot.
Good try.
Yeah.
Girl, Woman, Other by Bernardine Evaristo.
Yep.
Again, I don't really know much about this one. I'm assuming it's got some feminist stuff about it. It sounds like it's going to be some sort of study of how women are perceived in society or how they deal with things. So
the evolution of a character, it sounds like some type of journey that we're going to be kind of drawn into.
The Wall by John Lanchester.
Yep.
Now, I think you might know about John Lanchester. I think he did Paris or something, or London. One of those. No, I thought you had a big epic book that was about a nation. Well, okay.
Must be another boyfriend.
It must be. The Man Who Saw Everything by Deborah Levy. Again, I don't know anything about the actual book.
Yep.
All I know about Deborah Levy is that she did Milkman, which I have on my list to read.
Yeah.
And it was received with a fair bit of controversy when it was nominated. So she's a second time nominee of the Booker Prize in the last couple of years.
Do you know what was so controversial about it?
I don't know. The book was called Hot Milk.
Okay.
All I understand is that it wasn't necessarily well written or that people couldn't quite understand. It didn't seem like it merited being on the list.
Oh, okay.
But these things always, you need a little bit of controversy for these types of prizes.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, it's what drums up the excitement.
Yeah, and it's always interesting as well, given that Atwood's such a favourite of today, when really a lot of her works were considered previously as genre fiction, so weren't considered literary fiction for the purposes of the Booker Prize, and now they're just clamouring to get her on there.
I think that's it. I think particularly as well, you'll find that when there's exceptional novels written in different kind of genres, you know, say that they will get a little bit looser in their definitions over time.
Yep. So, Lost Children Archive by Valeria Luiselli. Yep. I'm assuming that's Italian, but we'll see. I don't know anything else about it. And we'll just go straight into the next one because I don't know anything about this one either. An Orchestra of Minorities by Chigozie Obiama. Mm-hmm. So, I have read, I think it's her work before. I think half of Yellow Sun she might have done.
Okay.
Then we've got Lanny by Max Porter. I haven't read anything else by Max Porter. This should be a good one, though. Now, Quixote or Quixote or something by Salman Rushdie.
Yep.
So Salman Rushdie, obviously very well known. I've actually never read anything by Salman Rushdie. I know Midnight's Children is the one that's constantly talked about with me. I've got The Golden House, I think, on my list.
Yeah, I think we started reading that one. Mm. That one came out a couple of years ago, right?
I think it was the most recent one before this.
Yeah. Obviously he's from Satanic Verses Fame / The Authority.
Yes. And also, this one's about Don Quixote, I think. And that's all I know about it.
Interesting.
So that should be fun. 10 minutes, 38 seconds in This Strange World by Elif Shafak.
Sounds like a short book.
So I've read The Bastard of Istanbul previous to this one. I haven't read any of her other works, but I've understood that she is quite awesome at writing in that Turkey lifestyle.
Okay.
I have actually read very recently 10 minutes, 38 seconds. And it's really, it's an interesting premise. It's from the perspective of someone, and I'm sorry to spoil things here, but it happens in the first few pages, but she's actually dying.
Oh.
And she's been killed, but she's, for 10 minutes and 38 seconds after she's actually killed, she has enough consciousness or awareness to consider memories and senses and things like that. So it kind of goes back when she's feeling her senses.
Mm-hmm.
In that 10 minutes and 38 seconds, we get glimpses of what's happened previously and where she gets those memories from, etc.
Interesting.
So I'll react to that one as well. And then finally, we've got Frankenstein by Jeanette Winterson. So we had the feminist ones, I guess. Yep. And Jeanette is... I would consider someone that you would read if you're a feminist as well.
Yeah.
But I think this is more catering to the transgender stuff. So okay. Frankenstein, I think, is going to be some transgender individual from their perspective. And I don't really know much else about it.
What will be interesting is will it carry through with the, I suppose, pervading myth that Frankenstein is the monster, not the doctor?
Yes.
That will be interesting.
Interesting.
That's interesting.
Interesting. I hope BookTube receives me for this one. Yeah,
so what's the plan? So you're going to go through and read each of these novels individually and give a review on them?
Yeah, or like a reaction.
Yep.
Probably with spoilers, just because, you know, I like to actually talk about stuff. Absolutely. You guys can easily Google what the book is about from the book blurb.
Yep.
I want to talk about what's actually happened and how I feel about it. But yeah, so that's it.
Exciting times.
Yeah, let us know, guys, if you guys are doing the book a reading challenge or whether you're just going to go with the short list coming up in October and whether or not you have any ideas on who might be winning the prize.
Yeah.
I usually make a bet on sports bet
and
win. Yeah.
Any initial leanings at this stage?
Well, out of the many that I've read, as in 2 out of 13.
Do you think actually Margaret Atwood's just going to ride on the Handmaid's Tale?
The Handmaid's Tale, yes. Possibly.
Yeah.
I actually really enjoyed My Sister the Serial Killer, but I don't think it's got the weight that a number of these are probably going to have.
Yep.
Frankenstein might be a good political agenda based one. I would actually like something like The Wall by John Lanchester. It sounds like that's a pretty big brick of a book. So I'd like to read that one and see if it holds up against the others.
Interesting. Yeah. Alright guys, let us know in the comments below. While you're there, hit like, hit subscribe, and we will see you next time.
Bye.